The third quarter now beginning. Both sides looking to pull away in the last half of the game. A fantastic game from DeMar DeRozan so far.
I like that he didn't force anything in that first half. His decision-making was really flawless.
That being the case, Steve, I think they want him to be more assertive in the second half. Look to take more shots. Be a little more shot-hungry, even the tough ones.
Toronto's gone 3-7 tonight from three-point territory.
It had been six straight years for the Celtics that they had made the playoffs, but that run came to an end last season as they were clearly in full rebuild mode.
Amir Johnson at the four with Valanciunas at the pivot. Lowry and Ross pairing up in the backcourt, and it's DeRozan in at the three. They're the group for Dwayne Casey starting the second half. Here's Rondo following the score by DeMar DeRozan. Outside Brandon. Back to Rondo. Six to shoot. And the wide open shot from Green. Misses the three. Well, a lot of storied franchises missed the playoffs last year, and Boston was one of them. But Steve, they knew it would be a tough season early on.
Well, trading away the talent they did, they knew how the season would play out. You know, ultimately it was the right thing to do, because they are in a good position to build upon youth going forward. He is just so good from that range, guys.
You know, never mind with the height advantage he had there.
Schoenger is screen on Lowry. Green, the pass to Brandon. And taken away by Johnson. Lowry dishes to Ross. Back to Lowry. And a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for two.
Kyle Lowry, an unrestricted free agent this offseason. Last year playing really well in a contract year. Question is, can he maintain that level of play now with this new deal?
At the line, and Lowry, one of the more underrated players in the NBA, but he's also gotten into it with two coaches shots in the past too, Clark.
Yeah, you know, some locker room concerns, he can rub folks the wrong way, but I tend to always want to give the player the benefit of the doubt in this situation until you know for sure what the issues are. Nothing wrong with a little sandpaper coming from a player that's out there competing.
No good on the second, so he hits one of two. There have been so many questions for the Boston Celtics the past two seasons. Who is going? Who's going to stay? Who should they build around? Tough to win with that.
Yeah, you've got those kind of questions rolling around. It's hard to find your direction and stay on course.
Green kicks to Bass, and a beautiful feed leads to a monster jam.
Some hang time on that rim puts a little whipped cream on that angel food cake there.
It's a tight ball game, and those displays of strength, Clark, can get one team rolling.
Agreed.
Oh, boy. Whipped cream, cherry on top. It always comes back to dessert for Clark.
The next step for the Celtics is going to be getting all this young talent to move together as a unit. Never an easy task for a coach.
Back to Green. It's Bradley on the wing. Outside, Green shoots from the corner. Bradley can't get it to go.
Well, hopefully for Boston, they'll be patient. But really, I think they have a lot to look forward to here in this city, as the Celtics could be a scary team in a relatively short amount of time.
Gets stolen by Lowry. Pass break. Here come the Raptors. Lowry's got the ball, and that one's good. Lowry's got 15.
He's been one of their more reliable options today, guys. I mean, his shooting has led them to this lead.
Passes it to Sellinger. Puts up a three. Basket is good. The assist from Rondo. And it's 8 points for Jared Sellinger. Raptors leading by three. Outside Lowry. And it's blocked by Rondo. And another shot. And there's the nice layup by Johnson. 8 points for him.
That's some more rugged play from them inside. They have a decent edge in rebounds thus far.
And that hard work on the boards needs to continue. That could be what swings this game eventually.
Now, here's Green. He's got 16. Back to Rondo. He dishes it to Bradley. Offline with his three.
More often than not today, those shots have not dropped for him.
Let's a floater go.
Some people might call him vertically challenged, but tell you what, his size didn't hurt him on that rebound.
His touch has disappeared on him this quarter. He just hasn't been able to get it going.
Now here's Rondo. He has six. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on DeMar DeRozan. Tyler Hansbrough has checked in for Johnson. Celtics also with a sub. Turner's checked in. Sellinger passes to Bass. The feed to Turner. Six on the shot clock. And that one's good. Turner's got 11 points.
Yeah, not just an everyday finish. He put a little pizzazz on that one, guys.
Was on the wing. Fires the three. And Boston with the rebound. Now Bradley. 9 points in the game so far. Shot denied. Now here's Ross. At the top of the key, Hansbrough. Outside Lowry. Toronto working the ball around now. The offensive rebound.
Very little success for him behind the arc today. Just 1 3-pointer in the first half and still none in the second.
Bass with a screen for Rondo. Bass with it. Hansbrough's there. Here's Sellinger. Lays it up and in off the pretty assist. Sellinger's got 5 points now in the quarter.
Well, they certainly didn't have much of a problem getting the ball into the post that time.
Well, that's important because this game, I think, is going to be decided by who controls the paint in crunch time.
Ross for three. And he gets it to go. Ross has got eight.
He's not going to miss many of those, if any. Not when he's got that much room.
Rondo dishes to Bass. Back to Rondo. He kicks it to Bass. Misses off the right iron.
Well, you know, head coach Brad Stevens of the Celtics is coaching a much different game in the pros than we see in college. I mean, a lot of differences. But if anybody can make that transition, I really think he's certainly the guy that could. He's bright. He's hardworking. He communicates well. He's innovative. Showed that innovativeness at the college level. So I think he's got all of the ingredients to become a college coach who is successful as an NBA coach.
Here's Rondo, following the score by DeMar DeRozan. Pass to Bradley. Outside Turner. Bradley kicks to Turner. Off target from outside. Toronto leading by six. This is DeLauer. Back to DeRozan. Ross with a wide open look. And the Raptors hit again from deep.
I'm not sure who was supposed to pick him up, but somebody's going to get an earful from the coach for leaving him that wide open.
Now a timeout called by Boston.
Well, there were a lot of amazing performances last season, but one that I didn't see coming was Terrence Ross notching 51 points early in 2014. That was just out of the blue.
Some changes for Toronto. Patterson, he's checked in for Hansbrough. And it's Williams in for DeMar DeRozan. And a new group in for the Celtics. Olynyk, he's checked in for Sellinger. Wallace comes in for Brandon Bass. Young's checked in for Bradley, and Smart subbed in for Rajon Rondo. Now here's Smart. Pass to Turner. There's the dish to Smart. Back to Turner. Here's Olynyk. Solid play in the low block, and that one's good. And with Ross and his big point explosion, Clark, the opportunity was there for him. It was after the Rudy Gay trade, and DeRozan was out at the time.
Yeah, and it showed just why Toronto is so high on Terrence Ross. I mean, he still needs to grow a bit as a player, but anytime you can score 50 or more in an NBA game, you know you've got game.
So it's Toronto now, following the bucket by the Celtics. Williams gets the bucket.
These defenders had better start closing out on those shooters.
Yeah, that's twice in a row now where they've done exactly the opposite and backed off.
Now here's Smart. Olynyk sets a screen for Smart. On the wing, Turner. There's the pass to Smart. Feeds it to Young. Kicks it to Smart. Shoots. Buries the jump shot. Smart's got six. Toronto leading by eight. Outside Williams. He feeds it to Patterson. Young against Williams. Passes to Valanciunas. The rebound by Young.
If he can improve on what's been a shaky day for him thus far, they could stretch this lead out.
Here's Smart. He has six. Here's Turner. Again, the Celtics good for two.
Guys, he shot a very good percentage today, and they've needed it.
Toronto's gone 3 of 5 with the long ball since entering the second half. Left side, Lowry. The three. Good. The nice assist for Williams. 18 points for Kyle Lowry.
A wide open three. They need much better communication defensively.
Smart with the ball. He dishes it to Turner. Clock at six. The feeds are Smart. He tries for three. Here's Olynyk. And the rebound paying off as they pick up two on the second chance bucket right there.
You know, it's a plus to get good looks in the paint. And when you can get them, you got to score.
And the Raptors call time here.
The Raptors weren't really dominant at home by any stretch last year, but they were a much stronger home team than years past, and I think that helped them get to the playoffs. No doubt about it.
And Toronto making a change here. Vasquez comes in. Celtics also with a sub. Marcus Thornton, he's checked in for Turner. And the Raptors with the ball. They've led by as much as 10. Vasquez kicks to Ross. Patterson setting the pick for Ross. The rebound by Young. Guys, you know the Raptors were solid, but not great at home. 26 wins was only fifth best in the entire Eastern Conference. But, Steve, they felt the advantage here in the playoffs.
Yeah, what a scene it was in this building last year during the postseason. The chants, the noise level. Almost felt like a European soccer match in terms of the atmosphere for that first-round series.
Raptors leading by five. 1:51 left in the third. Out to the wing. Valanciunas passes to Williams. Patterson dishes to Vasquez. Just five on the clock. Patterson, that's good. Patterson. 1:27 left here in the third quarter. Smart kicks to Olynyk. And another basket for Boston. .112 left to play in the third. Pass to Ross. Off the screen, and he comes off the screen and screams it through.
Well, I tell you what, it was the good pick that was set that turned him loose.
And once he got around it, Steve, it was smooth sailing right to the hole.
Well, because of the pick, he had plenty of room. That's why he was able to power down that slam.
Now here's Wallace. Wallace left side. Six on the shot clock. Shot from a low block. And another basket for Boston.
This has been a different kind of game here in the second half. I thought both clubs a little slow in the first.
No question, but they're really going at it now.
Here is Vasquez. 6 points for him. Baseline try, and again it's Toronto converting. Celtics trail by 7. And here's Smart. He's got 6. Thornton with a screen for Smart. He kicks it to Thornton. Beyond the arc. It's hauled in by the Raptors. Ross has got 5 rebounds tonight. And we've reached the end of the third. Raptors lead by 7. We'll be back shortly live from the Air Canada Center in downtown Toronto. And now let's go back to a play from earlier as we show you our State Farm assist of the game.
Well, this had to be the choice. It was an absolutely sensational feat, putting it way up there above the rim so that only his teammate could catch it. And not only does he do it, but he powers it down from there.
Yeah, the timing of these plays are just phenomenal.
No question.
And here's Rondo. And a look at the 5 for the Celtics to start the fourth quarter. We've got Green. Jared Sullinger is out there with Brandon Bass. Then it's Thornton. And it's Rondo in at the 1. Now here's Thornton. Shot clock at 6. A second chance effort. Shot is good, and the Toronto lead is cut to just 5 on the basket from Jared Sullinger.
You know, that putback's about as easy as it's going to get. You have to put a body on someone down there.
Well, no box out, that's the result you get right there.
Here's DeRozan. Dishes to Patterson. And that one swishes right in. And the Raptors lead by 7.
What a display of offense we've seen today, and it's only getting better.
Well, both defenses have been on their heels all day, and it's begun to take its toll.
Now, here's Green. Now Bass. Shot from 12. Somehow ignores the tight D and gets the layup.
Love the way he fought for that putback. You know, he's willing to put in a lot of hard work in this game, no doubt about that.
Pass to DeRozan. Patterson, a screen on Green. Patterson, the screen. It's DeRozan with the drive. No good off the pick.
Well, with that much space off the pick, you've got to drop that in.
Yeah, you got to make that one. I mean, that's a high-quality shot you should make 9 out of 10 times.
Now, here's Green. Outside, Rondo. To the inside, Bass. And here we go with DeRozan running it up the middle. Vasquez passes to Williams. Puts the fadeaway right on the money. Now here's Rondo. Over in the corner, Green. He's looking for Sullinger and finds him. Here's Bass. Here's Green. Shot is blocked. Shot is good, and the Toronto lead is cut to just 5 points on the basket from Jared Sullinger.
He's locked in right now, guys, hitting some big shots here in the fourth quarter.
Johnson with a screen on Thornton. Just over 2.5 minutes played now here in the final quarter of regulation. The 3 ball. Here's Patterson. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot 2 right here.
Way to play in attack mode and get inside.
And, you know, if you're on defense and you're going to foul, make sure it's a good one. They did, preventing the and one.
Shooting for Toronto, Patrick Patterson. Two shots.
That free throw good from Patterson. Kyle Lowry, he's checked in for the Raptors. Bradley's checked in for the Celtics. And Patterson drops them both. Celtics trail by seven. And we're about 3 minutes into the fourth quarter. Bradley dishes to Bass. Back to Bradley. Johnson with the puck. Here's Bass. Persistence pays off as they finally hit a shot. Bass has got 4 points in the quarter. And so here's Toronto. They've led by as much as 10. The dish to Vasquez. Johnson with a screen on Bradley. Lowry kicks to Vasquez. That falls. Nice feed that time from Kyle Lowry. Lowry's got 5 assists in the game. Well, the Celtics shooting at 52% from the field. They're clicking. Outside Rondo. There's the pick. Nice ball movement by Boston. Bradley kicks to Green. 6 to shoot. Rondo passes to Green. Here's Sullinger. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact and he'll shoot 2.
Well, Jared Sullinger's been getting it done. He's got 14 points and he's chalked up 1 3-pointer on the day as well.
And a lot of times he's one of those players who can get hot and stay hot from the 3-point line. So I look for him to continue to search for shots out there.
And the first one at the line is good.
Well, Jared Sullinger grew up with the game. His father was a demanding high school coach, and the word is that Jared was actually doing footwork drills at the age of 2, shooting regulation free throws by 3. You see how strong he is, and he's got a great IQ and skill for the game.
The free throw is good from Sullinger. And Sullinger's father coaching him to a state title his junior season at Northland High School.
Yeah, Sat's one of the outstanding high school coaches in the state of Ohio. Enjoying retirement now. And, you know, the season prior to that, they'd been eliminated from the playoffs after his father, Sat, sat Jared down for failing to turn in a school assignment. And he was sending Jared a message, no shortcuts, athletically or academically.
Absolutely.
He has really punished these defenders today. No matter who's been on him, he's been giving them medicine.
And let's quickly check out the scoring breakdown here for the Raptors.
I thought maybe they'd cool off a bit at halftime, but they've just continued to shoot well.
Boy, it's been a super performance from beyond the arc, too. I mean, they've been reining in those threes.
DeMar DeRozan, a first-time All-Star last year, he improved his long-range shooting. On wing threes, up around 40%, and that allowed him to shoot the best overall three-point percentage of his career.
And he gets it to go. And now it's an 11-point Raptor lead.
You know, they've been able to depend on his offense all game long, guys. He's drained a lot of shots out here.
And between now and the horn, Steve, the ball should be in his hands as much as possible if they want to continue to build this lead.
Time called here. The Celtics decide to talk it over.
And DeRozan last season cracking 30% from long range for the first time in his young, promising career. That outside shot has been the missing part of his offensive game because we know he can get to the rack.
Let's go quickly over to Doris Burke for an update.
Thank you, Kevin. Brad Stevens had some words for his team over the break. He let his players know that they've got to do a better job on defense. He said they're scoring any way they want. We've got to show some pride here. Let's make a stand defensively, get us stops, and get on a run of our own. Do they have it in them, Kevin?
Now, here's Green. Here's Bradley. Goes up to the stripe. There's the bucket. Good. They you talk about DeRozan attacking inside, Steve, last season among the top five in free throws made.
Yeah, 6'7", he's strong, he's athletic, you know, he has the ability to finish in the lane, and I just like the way he's improved as a passer as well, getting his teammates involved.
Here's DeRozan, following the score by Avery Bradley. Vasquez dishes to DeRozan. Green with the block.
He's been wayward and just off on about everything he's put up in this period.
Bradley kicks to Sullinger. Shoots a fader, and that one's good. Sullinger's got 13 points here in the second half alone.
He's been a bright spot for them. He's had an incredibly efficient offensive performance.
Steve, his shooting really has been just terrific. They'd be much worse off if it weren't for him, that's for sure.
Now here is Lowry. Patterson, the screen. Lowry passes to Patterson. The shot's good on the assist by Lowry. And the Raptors lead by 9.
The second he got around the pick and shook his man, it was straight to the bucket for the easy deuce. Very, very well done.
Here's Bass. Lowry down with both hands. And that's a double-double for him now. 10 points and 10 rebounds. They'd love to get more of those, the easiest 2 points possible. And on a fierce finish.
Yeah, and that's exactly how they're going to cut into the lead, Kevin.
Yeah, that's why they've got to tighten up their D. And I'd be surprised if the defense allows any more free runs to the hoop like that.
Here's Patterson after the basket by Boston. DeRozan dishes to Patterson. Johnson, a wide open look. And the Raptors tack on 2 more. Rondo with it. To the inside. With that shot, the Raptor lead is cut to just 7 points in the basket from Bass.
I like the fact that he led his teammate right to the ideal spot. You don't always throw it to your teammate. You throw it to where he needs to be.
Lowry against Rondo. Patterson a screen on Green. And DeRozan. Here we go.
Rajon Rondo, one of the NBA's elite playmakers. He's led the league in assists per game twice in the last 3 seasons. Great at keeping his dribble alive and forcing the defense to react.
No slowing him down, just some incredible numbers for DeRozan. 31 points, and he's been delivering a healthy dose of helpers, too.
Yeah, he really is. He's always looking to make the pass. His head up, eyes up, trying to find the open teammate.
That's good from DeMar DeRozan.
Kevin, right now, they're doing a good job at the line. They're hovering around 83, 84, 85% from the strike. That's good stuff. I mean, that's well done.
Jonas Valanciunas, he's checked in for Toronto. Ross comes in for Vasquez. No good on the second free throw. Celtics trail by 8. Outside Bradley. Rondo kicks to Bradley. And it's good coming on the assist by Rajon Rondo. 14 points for Avery Bradley. And for Rondo Clark, he has said, in essence, piling up assists instead of points is his way of being different.
Well, we know he likes to go to the beat of his own drum. He's very intelligent. He's a tremendous basketball player with a great IQ. You know, it's interesting, though, some have even accused him of being too unselfish when it comes to assists. So you got to be careful how you look at that. And he's always going to do it his way. So we'll watch and see how it plays out. They've stepped up their 3-point shooting game in the second half. They're letting it fly out there with reckless abandon.
Now they're feeling confident, and they're in a good flow offensively. So why not just keep firing from out there?
Now here's Rondo. Bass with a screen for Rondo. Back to Green. 6 to shoot. Here's Bradley. Rebounded by Valanciunas. Valanciunas has got the glass covered here tonight. 11 boards for him. Cross. That's good. And it's a 10-point Toronto lead. Boston's gone 1-2 from 3-point range here in the fourth. Rondo with it. Lowry picks him up. Green left side. Green left side. Six to shoot. Bradley kicks to Rondo. And they force the shot clock violation. Great team.
Well, dealing with travel, one of the challenges you face as an NBA player, it's amazing just how much easier it's gotten, Clark. I know you and I both played in an era early on where there was commercial travel. Now everybody charters and flies out immediately after a game. You've got legroom, you've got catered meals, so you get more sleep, you get more rest. I think it's had a huge impact on the way NBA teams do business and just the quality of play in general.
The drive by Lowry. Here's DeRozan, and fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot two. Jeff Green picks one up.
You know, Clark, those charter flights for NBA players are pretty cushy.
Yeah, you take a plane designed for 126 seats and put in 54. That creates a luxurious plane ride, man.
DeMar DeRozan. Two shots.
And the first one at the line is good. Both free throws good from DeRozan. And the Celtics with possession here. A 12-point game. Now a timeout called by Boston.
Well, I felt like his defense was letting him down out there, guys, so he wanted to get a timeout to talk it over, try to tighten things up here.
You know, a lot of coaching actually is making sure that momentum never gets too far away from your team. That's a good timeout.
And I think Doris Burke has something for us right now. Doris?
Hi, guys. Over that break, I was able to catch the message Brad Stevens was giving to his team. He wants to see renewed effort from them on the offensive glass. He talked about the second chance points that are out there if they work for them. He also said something you don't hear too often from a coach. He told his guys they should have a shoot-first mindset instead of trying to be, quote, too cute with the ball. A few late-on-the-fly adjustments as the situation gets more desperate for them. It's going to be a tough hill to climb, guys.
And thanks for that story, Doris. Now here's DeRozan after Jared Sullinger's miss. Lowry drives in. No luck. Now Boston takes it the other way. Bradley passes to Sullinger.
Boy, this has been flat out ugly for him this quarter. He hasn't hit a thing out there.
Guys, a good chance for them to slow it down.
Yeah, I agree. Got to use some clock here.
And Valanciunas kicks to DeRozan. On the wing, Johnson. Back to DeRozan. Out of bounds, Boston takes possession.
I'll tell you what, that's just a major unforced error right there, guys. My goodness.
Celtics trail by 12. Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, I mean, a cold stretch offensively. They desperately need a basket.
Sullinger dishes to Green. Back to Sullinger. And nothing is falling for him right now. Toronto's gone 2-3 in the fourth quarter from long range. Good shooting so far. It's DeRozan with the drive. Lowry kicks to Ross. And there's the whistle. Fouled hard on the shot. He'll go to the line.
Amir Johnson drafted straight out of high school back in 2005. Now in his 10th season in the NBA, and he's only entering his prime now.
And, you know, I'm all for young players going to college to develop, not only athletically, but socially and personally. But Amir Johnson is an example of a player who came straight out of high school, didn't play a whole lot at first, but has continued to work and has really rounded into a valuable player now.
That free throw good from Ross. And Amir Johnson, quietly one of the Raptors' best players. Steve, a very good player at both ends of the floor.
Yeah, he's a plus-minus stud for this team. He's a high-percentage scorer who also defends at a very high level. So this is a good two-way player.
Both good from the line that time.
You're hot. You're hot. And that's certainly been the case for Ross. He has 17 points, and from downtown, he's buried 3 three-pointers.
Yeah, when he's been able to get squared up and get a good look at the basket, it seems like everything's been going in.
Now a timeout called by Boston. They trail by 14. We've got 1:23 left to play here in the fourth.
We've got 1:23 left in the fourth quarter. Rondo drives in. Can't connect from short range.
Solid rebound there. And with the score like it is, that's a
throw down. Oh, man. This is unreal.
Mark it up.
And this is what they wanted, to announce their presence in this matchup with authority. Very decisive. And I think it can be considered a statement win for the Raptors.
They made more foul shots, and that was the difference.
And that was a huge advantage. The free throw game, always a significant barometer in terms of who wins and loses.
Five on the clock. To halt the run. Here's Sullinger, and a good offensive board, and he gets the bucket.
No matter what the score is, his attitude has been perfect. I love his disposition. He has stayed in attack mode.
And here's Lowry. Banked in off the glass. And the Raptors lead by 16.
And they're not finished yet. They're going to make sure about this win.
Yeah, that's how you close out a game, Steve.
The pass to Sullinger. It's stolen by DeRozan. 3 second difference between shot clock and game clock. Lowry kicks to Johnson. Feeds to Ross. Back to Johnson. And it goes as the official calls the foul. Count it. He'll shoot one more at the free throw line.
Celtics foul. Just a little bit more for these fans to cheer about as they get ready to celebrate the win.
Well, they can already start to celebrate, Steve, and they should. Let their team hear it. They were good.
One shot.
And that one falls for Johnson. And here we go with Marcus Thornton. And it's Turner off the drive. Kicks it to Thornton. Fires for three. That's good.
Marcus Thornton.
Now Vasquez. And so Toronto takes this one, but by a big margin. And this one was such a lopsided victory.
They never let up. They were full throttle from the start.
And time now to go courtside as we send you over to Doris Burke from the sideline. Doris?
Kyle, congratulations on this win. Tell us what the team's objective was tonight that most helped in getting this victory.
Everybody played. We all played together. You know, we stayed, you know, aggressive and stayed the course of the game.
Cohesiveness and aggressiveness, a pretty good combination. Thanks for the time, Kyle. Guys?
Thank you, Doris, for that. And now for Clark Kellogg, Steve Kerr, and Doris Burke. This is Kevin Harlan saying see you next time as we present our Jordan Player of the Game tomorrow.